Hi friends, so continuing with our session on polynomials, in this session we are going to discuss what all types of polynomials are. You know what a polynomial is. If you are not clear on that, I would suggest you can go back to our playlist and just watch the previous session. You'll get to know what polynomials are. Now in this session we are going to discuss different types of polynomials basis their degree, right? You know the degree. What is the degree of a polynomial? Degree of a polynomial is nothing but the power of the highest degree term, right? Is a degree of the polynomial. So first category or first type is nothing but constant polynomial. Constant polynomial. So as the name suggests, constant polynomial is nothing but a polynomial of degree zero. What is it? A polynomial. So it is a polynomial of degree zero. That means it is a constant degree zero. So for example, examples are, let us say fx equals to, let's say 91, okay, or gt in variable is t, so let us say 42. All are degree zero terms, right? Degree zero terms. So hence they are called constant polynomial, okay? Now there is one concept called zero polynomial. So in this constant polynomial, if the value is zero polynomial, right? What is a zero polynomial? So if any polynomial is that there fx equals to, let's say, zero, it's called a zero polynomial. But the problem is the degree of this is not defined. Degree of a zero polynomial is not defined, okay? It's not defined. Why? Because if you see, zero polynomial can be written as 0 times x to the power 1. This can be equal to 0 into x to the power 2, or this can be 0 into x to the power 99 or whatever, right? It's very difficult to find out then what will be the degree of zero polynomial. So please remember, zero polynomial degree is not defined. Okay, this is one case. Now second category is linear polynomial. So you have studied about linear polynomials time and again. Linear polynomials. What are linear polynomials? So let us say, and we are again going to deal only with one variable. So px is equal to, let us say, 7x minus 5. This is a linear polynomial. Why? Because if you see, the highest term, degree term, is 7x, whose degree is 1. Similarly, gt is equal to, let us say, minus root 2 t plus 47. So here also, this is linear polynomial. Or hy is equal to 47t. Oh, sorry, it cannot be in t. It has to be in, let's say, y. So 47y. These are all examples of linear polynomials. And if you notice, the maximum number of terms in linear polynomials could be 2 only, right? So one will be the term containing x, and the other could be the constant term. So max number of terms possible in a linear polynomial is 2. Then comes your very famous quadratic polynomial. So you already know, or even if you don't know, quadratic polynomials are nothing but polynomials of degree 2. So example, px is equal to root 2 x square minus 3x plus 4. This is one. Then qx, let us say, is equal to 7x square. This is also another, where the other two terms are not there. And let us say g of x is equal to, let us say, 5x square minus 27x. All are examples of quadratic polynomial, guys. Now here, if you see again, maximum number of terms possible is 3. Maximum number of terms is nothing but 2 plus 1. Quadratic degree is 2 plus 1 is 3, right? This is another understanding. Similarly, on similar lines, you can, there is something called cubic. Now cubic is nothing but degree will be 3. Degree is 3. So example, px is equal to 3x cube minus 27x square plus 90x minus 7. Or gt could be, let us say, 3t cube minus 27t. right? Or h of, let us say, y is equal to y root 2y root 2y cube, and let's say that's it. So all these are degree 3, and again max number, if you see max number of terms, you can now guess very easily, is nothing but 3 plus 1 is equal to 4 max. It need not be having 4 terms all the time. For example, if you see here, only one term is there, but still it is cubic. Why? Because the highest term, highest degree term is this 3. Okay, similarly, there are, you know, you can have n number of this thing. For example, the next one is bi-quadratic. Bi-quadratic, where you have, you would have guessed by now, degree is 4. Degree is 4. And then there are things like quintic and so on and so forth. These are, so sixth one is quintic, where the degree is 5. So you would have now known, if degree is 4, max number of terms is, max number of terms will be nothing but 5. And in this case, max number of terms will be 6. Understood? So this is one categorization of polynomials. So we saw what all: constant polynomials, we saw zero polynomial, we saw linear polynomials, quadratic polynomial, cubic, biquadratic, and quintic. All these polynomials in themselves have different properties, and all these properties will be studied under polynomials. Okay, so we'll be taking up in this particular series of sessions, we'll be taking up talking about constant polynomial, we'll be talking about linear, quadratic, and then cubic, right? And then we'll see what is meant by their zeros and other related properties.